All right, guys, we're back. Had a little technical issues here going on with the game, the Dolphin emulator, because it seems to tax a lot the processor. And since there's a lot going on, you know, it's basically normal. It's normal that things like this could happen. But let's try it out now. Let's see what happens. Let's boot it up. I tweak a couple of settings, bring down probably, it'll be, the quality of the video will probably go down quite a bit too, but these are sacrifices that need to be done in order for the game to run the way it should. Now, let's see, let's go into the screen, and let's check out how this fares now. The controller. Awesome, Anthony. Awesome. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for the support, man. By the way, any of you guys who love Neo Geo, be it hardware, games, or whatever, please go by the Atari Age website, specifically the Neo Geo thread. There, Anthony, my man here, is going to take care of you guys with plenty of awesome stuff for the Neo Geo fans. Now let's see. Let's actually start from the beginning and see how it, because so far it's looking to be a bit more stable. You can hear it here and there a little bit, but at least it's working a bit better, and it's the resolution actually. Now I know what to do in case it starts bogging down again, so don't worry guys, we'll work it little by little. Okay, no, we don't run the tutorial. Let's do this. The awesome thing about this game is the fact that it makes you, or obligates you to switch weapons, because here the weapons actually break, and you need to give them time in order for the weapons to actually heal or restore themselves. So that gives a kind of like a tension dynamic, and making you take care of your own weapons and stuff. Something that's kind of unheard of in beat-em-ups. You just, you know, grab the first weapon and that's it. So basically here, you use a button for changing. See, that's one of the main weapons, and you have another one. There's a total, I believe there's a total of 108 swords that you get to collect in the game. And the other cool feature about this game is the fact that eventually, not now, it's not open now because it's just, you know, beginning the game, but you have a cooking element where you get to prepare your own foods for healing and stuff like that. Plus you get to basically upgrade, kind of like a RPG system, towards the action, you know, where you get to upgrade your weapons and use special abilities and stuff. And the way that the map is designed in a way where you do a lot of backtracking, kind of like the Metroid series, that Metroidvania kind of a map where you go but you get stuck at some point where you have to back travel and collect other stuff, and that way the map keeps opening little by little. That's the way it works here in Muramasa. So now it's actually, I think it's very playable now. Now I can deal with it. Now I can't talk enough about how beautiful this 3D art looks. It's incredible. I mean, it's incredible. This game is, besides the basic, right now, since there's no enemies on screen, I cannot unsheath the sword. However, once you get enemies on screen, it gives you a wide variety of stuff that you can do, and the moves are incredible too. If you go through the tutorial, you notice that you have basically, the controls are kind of like Smash Brothers, in the sense that whatever direction you point the pad or the joystick or whatever, you'll have a move. So it adds to the complexity of something that's simply supposed to be a button mash, into something much more complex and much more satisfying to play. So now I have to move towards the right. And the game is very story focused. You know, you need to hit certain points in order for the story to advance. It might not seem it for now, because now we're starting out and... But yeah, it does develop into something a little bit more complex. Please do, Anthony! Don't miss out! Now the game is running really good. Change, and you got your special attack. It even gives you, it's pretty quick, and you need to practice it a lot to get the timing down, but even by switching weapons, in the middle of unsheathing and sheathing the sword, that's a special move. But it has, you know, you can't over abuse it. Alright, Anthony, you're back in the game with us, good. Because whatever resolution a lot of people complain about this game, oh no, this game should be on 360 and PlayStation 3. Oh no, they're doing a disservice to the game. Oh boy, here we go. No, I'm not going to be caught in a rant. Nope. I'm just going to celebrate the fact that this Vanillaware game, because you guys know about Dragon Crown, which came out on a PS Vita later on, the art on that game is basically amazing. I still haven't had a chance to get a PS Vita, and at this point it's gonna take me some time, but Vanillaware, with, you know, their art style is excellent. It's incredible. I think I hold them in very high regards in terms of their capabilities of drawing these worlds. And this art style is just too much. It's beautiful. You're not gonna break my sword, man. No, you won't. Now let me and see how my health is doing. I'm doing okay. Now, another thing. thanks, Aaron. What do you mean on mute, Anthony? You can't hear it? Check out your video player to see how it's. All right. Okay. Just you guys let me know, because these things happen, and I don't want to be caught by surprise. You guys let me know if anything is going wonky on your side. All right. Another thing about this game that I find incredible is after you learn and you master the different moves, you have two settings or two difficulties, if you may, where you can play the game. In the beginning, you get to choose from Muso and the other one to the right, I forgot the name, I think Shuri or something like that, or Shura. The difference between them is not difficulty, it's structure. And I love that, because instead of giving you a game where you have just easy, normal, hard, the difficulty in this game changes the whole mechanics of the game and how you play the game. For instance, in Muso, the one that I'm doing now, is more RPG-like. Basically, you start collecting stuff and leveling up and gathering your moves and stuff little by little until eventually you complete the story. If you want something more action-oriented, but really hard, and time base, you choose the next one, the Shura difficulty. There you don't have to worry about, you know, gathering weapons and stuff like that. It's just simply going balls out, kicking and fighting until the very end. Very challenging. I'm doing the Muso right now because I want to show you guys how the system works in terms of gathering stuff. And of course, I'm an RPG fan, so basically, if you can give me some elements, RPG elements, in any game, I'll take them. Now, I switch. Oh! I didn't get to use a move. And the combos here, oh my god, the combos are glorious. Okay, I got a healing pellet. I need to use one of these. There you go, all healed up. The only thing that confuses me a little bit, and it's because I've been playing with the 360 controller for so long now, that I keep forgetting that the Nintendo placement is very different from the controllers that we use nowadays. So that A button, that crucial A button, I always get it mixed up. Right now I'm playing this with a DualShock 3 controller, so well, this actually, and ironically, Aaron, this game originally came out for the Wii. This game, you will still find it for the Wii in a bargain bin. And it's so awesome. And now I believe they came out with a sequel or a remaster, if you will, for the PS Vita called Muramasa Rebirth. It's sad because after the Wii's quote-unquote death, it's when I started to hear about so many hardcore games for the system. You know, and it's very sad because one of the things that people used to argue and complain was that Wii was for casuals and it didn't have any games. It didn't have any good games. So, you know, which is as you guys should know by now, is a bunch of bullshit. Yeah. Yes, it has a whole bunch of shovelware and crapware, just like every other system. But it has many, many gems, and many of them people don't even know about. Just because they decide, you know, it's better to hate instead of just taking time to explore a system, I guess. I'm gonna get to kick your ass! Okay. The game has its own parry system, which is very simple to use. You basically hold the button, hold the sword in front of you, and if you time it correctly, when they throw the projectile weapons at you, you can fling them back. You know, just swipe them and hit them back to the enemy, so it's really cool. Yes, Mad World, sadly, it was a shame that it didn't sell as much as it should have, because that's the whole point. Mad World comes out, which is gory and, you know, it's fun, because, you know, it's fiction. It's gory to the max. Basically, one of the things that, again, many fanboys were complaining, no, the system and Nintendo are for kids. They don't have adult-themed games, so this is like the holy grail of something mature and gory and violent, and people don't pick it up. So then you can't complain. Okay, so far, guys, it's pretty straightforward, as you can see, because the game is basically trying to ease me into the mechanics and stuff, but I don't mind that there are large spaces that you get to traverse, because everything looks so beautiful, and it has so many parallax scrolling stages that, oh my god, it's like, it's eye candy. How is that even possible, Anthony? Oh no. And that's a crying shame. I wanna talk to you guys. Maybe if you could try, Anthony, to reload the whole page. You know, just close the tab and open the tab again in the browser. It'll probably help. That's weird. Yeah, just close, tell him to close the tab. If he's on a desktop, tell him to close the tab where the browser, where the site is, the hitbox tab. Close it and just reload it again, just reopen it. Maybe there's some things the audio didn't pick up when he refreshed. Yeah, that should help. Two more saves here. Oh, what happened? Did I actually... Oh my god, I actually... got out of the game. I didn't even notice. Okay, right here, right here. Muramasa, no change. Okay, so we go forward. Yep, and that's Metal Slug 7 is one of the games that I'm gonna be featuring in the DS special that I'm doing, because it's badass to the core. It doesn't even look like a DS game. It's incredible. Okay, so now we're going to boss territory here. Oh Lord, I need a smoke. That's messed up. Don't tease, man. I wish. Again, I think this is like my second day without being able to smoke. Okay, this one is done. There you go. And that's the problem when you don't smoke, you start getting all cranky and crabby and oh my god. It gets to a point where my head hurts even. So I'm trying not to let it get to me too much. I love the voiceover.
裏で糸を引くのは誰じゃ。覇気は人質に命を絶つ。嫌というなら是非も。殴り切りで楽には死ねんぞ。何の話か皆目見気がついた時には頭から覚悟がすっぽり抜け落ちて、てめえが誰かも分かりゃしねえ。
True, man. I hope it happens soon. I need to go back to the States. I need to go back to my family in New York. Whatever, or I don't know how many of them are left there, if they're still there anymore. But I need to go back. Okay, this is the boss fight, guys. The first boss fight. And check it out. Kick ass. Check him out.
Boss.
Here we go. And this guy ain't no joke. He will break your swords in an instant. Woohoo! As long as you don't let this guy sit on you or jump on top of you, I think you're good. Oh, he's gonna break it. Some of that, baby. No! Okay, good, good, good. Nice. Oh, the sword broke. There you go, night glow. Get over here. Woohoo! Gotcha, good baby. Get over here. Jump! Nice. Holy crap, you saw that? He just sits down, jumps on top of you, and that's it. It's over. Breaks the sword automatically. Get out of there. Okay. Now I gotta let the other two swords basically repair themselves inside the sheath. Jump! Oh! Don't tell me I'm left without any swords. Okay, this one. Got this one back. Little juggling action there. Jump! Ah, crap. She may attack. Alright, Negler. Awesome. Jump! Now he's pissed. I think this is the last energy bar he has. You won't. You ain't gonna catch me. No. Shurikens are too much, man. Hey, let's get the cyclone going. Jump! It's at half his strength. There you go. That'll take the chunk off of you. And he's gone. How is that even possible, Anthony? Aaron, do you hear me fine? I mean, is there any, like, feedback or anything messed up with sound? Man, it's a crying shame, too. I wonder what's wrong. Maybe it's not loading in his browser for some reason, the sound. But if he's getting the sound from the game, I don't understand why he's not picking up voice. It's weird. Okay, so I got now a new sword. And each sword has its own properties and stuff, which is awesome. This one in particular is the one that I need in order to break a barrier that's at the very beginning of the game. Yeah, the browser could be it too. If he's using like Edge or Firefox or something like that, it might be giving him some trouble. If he's using Chrome, that's the weirdest thing. Chrome is the least one that gives people trouble. And this, I don't know. It's crazy. Well, Anthony, you could try tell Anthony to switch browsers and see if that works. Okay, so basically... Explain here that these foxes work with the Muramasa clan of swordsmiths. And they explain also that you need those green orbs, or basically souls that you need to repair and actually build the swords. So everything here is needed. Everything you pick up, all of those little swords, souls, I'm sorry. Yes. Now I'll be stopping at around 7, my time over here. I'm guessing it's 6 o'clock over there, or it will be 6 o'clock over there where you're at, Aaron. And then take that hour and come back at 8 o'clock to continue. Basically, I gotta go all the way back to the first screen. Yeah, let me save. Very important. All the way back to the first screen in order to use the newly acquired sword so I can open the barrier that wasn't letting me go towards the left in the beginning. That's why I had to walk all the way towards the right many screens. Nagasone Kotetsu. Oh, you mean I gotta let go of one of these? That sucks. I'm gonna let go then of this one and change it for the Nagasone. Nagasone Kotetsu. Of course, you got a button for the map, and this is basically okay. Now we can go back all the way back to the beginning, with maybe a few fights here and there, probably. A lot of people complain while or when reviewing this game for the first time that even though they found it to be incredible, they didn't enjoy the fact that he did a lot of backtracking, or you had to do a lot of backtracking instead of having fast travel. Again, it seems like a complaint that is more based in laziness than anything else. I mean, if you have a beautiful world like this, why should it be any problem for you to walk around in it? You know, it's like they look for whatever excuse to complain and bitch about stuff. Jeez. Alright. Alright, so Anthony is back with us now. Now he can listen to me. We can talk to each other now. Oh my god. So, it was that bad, huh? Maybe Anthony got a little bit of that curse that I got for Silent Hill. A little bit seeped into his computer and stuff. we approach that barrier that needs to be. But like I say, Aaron, it's growing pains, man. You gotta take the good with the, you gotta take the bad with the good. Everything and anything can happen. That's the whole thing about doing this stuff live, man. And one of the reasons that a lot of people, very talented people, actually don't want to do streaming, because they know, especially if it's a person, say, that has a lot to lose if they are looked at differently in the eyes of the public, they know that they can't mess up. You know, they can't slip. They can't be the person they're trying to be on a video, because now it's live. You know, this is what you get. So a lot of people, they tend to avoid that. It's uncomfortable. But for the people who enjoy it, I guess, you know, it's a good time. Oh, shit, the chupacabra. That would have been messed up. That would have been really messed up if it were the chupacabra. Be careful, Anthony. Chupacabra ain't no joke. Okay. Also, just like you expect from an action game that's based on ninjas, the control is absolutely perfect. Here, or in any time that I get my ass kicked, it's my fault. It's not the controller's fault. It's not the gameplay mechanics. It's my fault. It's that the game is too much for me, and I need to practice. But it's not too hard. It's not too cheap. No. The system is well thought out and planned out and executed perfectly. So, no complaints. It's like playing a miniaturized version of Ninja Gaiden. And I'm not talking about the 2D arcade one. I'm talking about the Xbox, the Ninja Gaiden Black, that, you know, is hard as nails, but the control is so damn good that you don't want to let it go. Well, translate that into 2D, and you have this game right here, right there. Here's the barrier waiting to be shattered. Now I can head to the next part of the adventure. And we get to see some new scenery. But of course, I'm gonna do the smart thing, and before we head on, I am going to save my game, not in-game, mind you, but in the emulator. Because that way, when I come back at around 8 o'clock or 7 Eastern time, it'll be right exactly where I left it. Look at this. It's freaking awesome. Bullshit. Trying to trick me? Woohoo! The thing is, it becomes addictive. it becomes very addictive. In the beginning, there's a lot of moves like to take in and try to memorize. Right now, there's a few that I know that I'm missing that I'm not using at all. But once you get it down, it's like, oh man. You get the same high that you get from a shooter, which is also, you know, how can you say it, a skill base, you know. There's timing involved. Here we go. Serious? Oh my god, I didn't know it was gonna be so problematic tonight. Well, the best thing, guys, I think I'm gonna take that break that I mentioned and come back at 8 o'clock, which would be 7 o'clock Eastern. We'll see what happens then. I'll keep on tweaking my settings over here to see if I can help whatever's, you know, you guys see over there. So hopefully it'll be better by the time I come back. All right, so I see you guys. Thanks a lot for watching till now. If I don't see you guys when I come back, then thanks for being here, thanks for giving me support, and I hope you enjoyed what I've done so far and what I have to bring up to, bring to the table later on, okay? So you guys take care, bros.